Well, good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com, and welcome to Thursday morning. In this presentation, I was hoping to announce that we had new buy signals for the XAU and the TSX Gold Index, but unfortunately, that is not the case. We got pretty close, but just didn't make it on Wednesday, and so we'll have to see if we can get there on Thursday. We are certainly at a time and place where we are looking for buy signals, and certainly some stocks have generated buy signals yesterday, and there are some stocks in this sector that are still on buy signals, didn't go down with the rest of the market. But here we are at the bottom of the panic zones on the XAU. Now notice this pressure zone is elongated here. So, you know, we were looking for a bigger rally off this bottom, didn't get it. And we are continuing to make a series of lower highs. So it's going to take a lot to change that pattern. We are projecting above the previous highs, but wouldn't be surprised if we put in a lower high here. Now the XAU found support at an open gap, and that open gap support is still holding. If it breaks, of course, then we look for move down to retest those lows down there on the left from late 2016. Now looking up, on the right side chart, we traded through the upper trend line yesterday, but did not hold the close. We still have to close a dime higher on Thursday to generate that buy signal. Looking at the TSX, notice the TSX has been weaker, the TSX Gold Index. We've taken out those lows, so we are certainly making lower lows here. But once again, we found support at an open gap. We broke through the first one here, went down, found support at that one. That one is currently holding. So some panic selling down here. We've got a pressure zone. This is the time and place where we look for a buy signal. Once again, we didn't get it yesterday. Still looking for that close above the upper channel line on Thursday. Now, there has certainly not been any market love for this sector in 2017. The XAU is still up a little over 2% on the year, and that's better than the TSX Gold Index. But if you look at it over the last year, we're down over 23%. And so that certainly does not look good on a spreadsheet comparing sectors of the market. Now, looking at the seasonality from the peak in early May, we get a seasonal rundown into early August. And so that's what we're looking for right now. We're in that area, so potentially we could be putting in a summertime bottom right now, holding support at those open gaps. And then from that early August seasonal low, we get a move up into late September, early October. And so that's the next move that we're looking for in the market. Now, one thing that could totally screw up the seasonalities this year is that in August, we're going to have a total eclipse of the sun in North America. And that is an unusual event and could be a market disturbing event as well. So just to keep that in the back of your mind, that is coming up and could screw up our seasonalities. Now, what I was hoping to do today is go through all the stocks in the XAU and show you all the new buy signals. There are still stocks that are on buy signals. Some stocks generated buy signals yesterday. But, you know, the ones that I'm looking at, Barrick, no change there. Traded up through the upper channel line but closed below it. Agnico-Eagle, similar situation. Goldcorp, similar situation. Closed pretty close to the upper channel line but did not close above it. Kinross, big reversal yesterday after trading higher and closing lower on the day. And then we've got Yamana. For Yamana, we're still looking for a close above 315 on Thursday. And so if we get buy signals in the XAU and the TSX Gold Index, I will come back and go through all the charts in the XAU and take a look at where they are. But we're not going to do that this morning. There's no reason to. Still waiting for those buy signals to come through. Thank you very much for your time this morning. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.